Hello the internet, my name is Cecilia, welcome back to my channel. I know, long time no see, am I right? And today I am back with another speedpaint video, which I haven't done in like over half a year, which is crazy. I have been drawing a lot actually. I just didn't really draw anything that was like, I don't know, like spectacular enough to show off in a video, because I mean, I set up pretty high standards with, you know, like the speedpaint videos that I have uploaded over the last year. Even though there weren't many of them, the ones that I did post were usually like, you know, like up there, like they were usually quite detailed portraits and stuff like that. And so this time I was inspired by the new Star Wars Han Solo movie. Yes, I'm still very much into Star Wars. I'm really obsessed with it. I'm not planning to go back anytime soon. Well, you know, like it's impossible to go back to not being obsessed with Star Wars, but you know, not planning to get out of that hole anytime soon. But yeah, so basically this is already in itself a major spoiler for the movie, but I mean, like, the movie has been out for almost a month now, so I think it's pretty safe to post this kind of spoilery stuff online. Anyway, so this is the character Enfys Nest, which is a new character in the Star Wars universe, which is a new universe and has a lot of characters, but she's one of my new favorites, actually. She's probably now among my, like, top 5 favorite characters in Star Wars, which is crazy for someone who has, like, a combined 3 minutes of screen time, maybe like 2 minutes, you know, if you really like, you know, like if you really think of it. But I just love everything, you know, like her look, her outfit, what she's about, and she has this amazing curly reddish hair and freckles, and I was just in love and I had to draw her. The hair in this picture turned out a lot more vibrant than, you know, like the actress's natural hair, but I just felt like doing something more vibrant, especially with the lighting that I had going on. And I was actually inspired by another drawing that I think someone did of a Marvel character with basically a similar lighting, where like there's a strong light going from behind, and then there's some like reflection from the ground or from the character's clothing that, you know, like lights up their face from below. So I'm always a fan of that lighting. I don't get to practice that enough, and this was really good practice. I loved drawing this picture so much. I haven't had this much fun painting a picture in a while. Well, I haven't like painted a picture this big in a while in general, so this was loads of fun. You'll probably see me like, you know, like moving parts around of the picture and editing it, you know, like in ways that you obviously couldn't do in traditional art. And that's why I love digital art. You can literally like pick up, you know, like for example, one of the eyes and just move it very slightly or rotate it, you know, like so, you know, like to make it more even. And that's one of the many perks or digital art, and why I always stick to it, and why it's always my go-to art, unless I have to make a greeting card or a birthday card for someone in the family, that I'll, you know, like pull out my pencils and stuff like that. But digital art has given me so much more flexibility and stuff like that, and I think that's something that's always gonna stay with me. I didn't do a sketch at the beginning, as you could probably see, so I spent quite a lot of time messing around with the structure of the face and like moving things around and stuff like that, because not only the lighting is, you know, quite difficult to, you know, like to accurately paint, but also, you know, like it's pretty tricky to, you know, like get the face anatomy, you know, mostly right without sketching. And I know a lot of artists, you know, like swear by using references and like measuring everything and making like 50 billion sketches, and I'm like, I admire that, but I don't have the patience for that. I will get bored after 2 hours of painting and I'll be like, I'm done. That's why my style is usually very painterly and abstract. And if I really, 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 really want to like make a project that is really big and can, you know, like consumes a lot of my time, maybe like days, then, you know, like that will be like once a year or something like that. Because first and foremost, art is fun. It has to be fun. And that's exactly what this was. So of course, in the movie, Enfys Nest, like the whole, you know, like her taking off her mask is probably one of the biggest reveals of the movie, aside from like the biggest reveal of the movie, which I still don't want to talk about, because like, especially for Star Wars fans, that was like a major thing that everybody was in shock of, you know, like, so, you know, like that one I'm not gonna talk about. But basically the whole unmasking of Enfys Nest was so beautiful and so shocking and so beautifully done, and, you know, like everybody that I talked to instantly fell in love with this character after, you know, like she took off her mask and did her little speech and stuff like that. And I just I'm just in awe of how adorable, but how strong and intimidating at the same time Enfys Nest is in the movie. And I know that the Han Solo movie didn't do really well in box office and it was considered a flop, but I really, really hope that they will make a sequel to that, because not only, you know, like Enfys Nest is a character that has so much potential and is one of my favorites, but also there were a lot of other things in the movie that, you know, like raised a lot of questions and you left the theater really, really wanting a sequel, no matter how you felt before about, you know, like Han Solo, you know, like the movie turning into a trilogy. Well, that's basically just like deep fandom stuff. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed this. I definitely enjoyed making it. If you want to see more of my art, I have a playlist called Watch Me Draw, where I put pretty much every single speed paint that I've done over the years. And also I do have a Redbubble page where I have put up some of my art, where you can get like prints or mugs or pillowcases and stuff like that. Well, pretty much merchandise with my art on it. People usually get like stickers and posters and stuff like that, and I think it's really cool. So yeah, that'll be it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. Make sure you subscribe to this channel, because I will be sure to post more speed paints in the future and various random videos in general, whatever I feel like making. And of course music, let's not forget music. I do that too. I'm still working on new songs. So yeah, thank you so much for watching this video, and I will see you next time. I love you guys. Bye. Mwah!